Arirang Special. Japan mobilized its military using the incident where Japanese monks were beaten by Chinese as an excuse and won the subsequent battle. This is known as the Shanghai Incident. 3 months later, on the day of the emperor's birthday, Japan was celebrating its victory. A light rain was falling that day. While a microphone was crackling, a young man walked up to the platform. He unslung the water canteen around his shoulders and threw it towards the platform. The platform erupted in chaos. Most of the Japanese leaders up on the platform were either dead or injured. The young man who had thrown the bomb was Yun Bong-gil, who used to be a greengrocer. Yun Bong-gil, what had made him throw that bomb? Why did he sacrifice his life in a far-off land? We went to his hometown of Yesan, Chungcheongnam-do Province. He lived here from the moment he was born until he left the country. This is Johandang, the house he lived in. It means a house that will save Korea. For generations, Yun Bong-gil's family had been ordinary farmers. Yun Gyusang and Yun Suil are the two people who remember Yun Bong-gil's family. Yun Bong-gil was born here at Gwanhyeondong in 1908. It was 2 years before the Korea-Japan annexation. His great-grandfather was the first to settle in Doksan, and Yun Bong-gil lived in this house with his grandfather and father. In the neighborhood, Yun Bong-gil's grandfather was known as the mall, meaning that he was a very hard-working farmer. They did not have to worry about food. But after the annexation of Korea in 1910, their troubles began. In the year 1876, Joseon succumbed to Japan's pressure and opened its doors. Guerrillas rose up nationwide in the cause of justice and fought against Japan's ambitions. But in 1905, Joseon lost its diplomatic rights. This was called the Usa Treaty. Emperor Gojong sent secret envoys to the Hague Peace Conference to tell the world about Japan's atrocities. However, the envoys failed to get into the conference hall. They handed out plea letters asking world leaders to assist in Korea's independence, but even this plan was foiled due to Japan's obstructions. 2 years after the Ulsa Treaty, Japan forcibly disbanded the Korean Empire's army. Some committed suicide, unable to bear the shame. Guerrilla fighters spread like wildfire, but it was not enough. In the end, Japan mobilized its army to subdue the Korean Empire's army and marched into Seoul.
1908년 그 당시의 상황이라고 하는 것은 그 일본이 한국을 대한제국을 차지할 수 있도록 열강이 미국이나 영국이나 이런 열강들이 무슨 뭐 영일 동맹이나 그다음에 그 포츠머스 강화 조약이나 그런 걸 통해서 일본이 한국을 보호국으로 만드는 것을 다 승인했죠. 그죠. 그래서 어떤 나라도 한국을 일본의 침략으로부터 도와줄 수 있는 나라도 없고 하소연할 나라도 없는 그런 상태가 1908년 상황이죠.
1910. This was the year the Korean Empire disappeared into the pages of history, and the Korean people became a colonized people without a country. It was also the year Yun Bong-gil turned two. This is Doksan Elementary School, the school he attended. There is a statue of Yun Bong-gil in the schoolyard. What will the children know about Yun Bong-gil?
Yun Bong-gil.
어떤 사람이에요?
몰라요.
몰라?
도시락 폭탄 드는.
또?
It is said that Yun Bong-gil was extremely competitive as a child. A sturdy and determined little boy, he was always the leader among his friends. Being competitive, he couldn't bear to lose to anyone. So his friends called him the Wildcat.
상대하고 씨름을 하면 이기고 만다 이게. 추매 해서 진다 이게. 지면은 이길 때까지. 점심 오전 중에 승부가 안 나면 밥 먹고 오라고 그래서 또 시작한다 이게. 그래서 끝끝내 이기고 난 후에 결국 이제 끝난다. 그래서 동네 친구들이 윤이 잡으면 징그럽다 그러죠.
Yun Bong-gil learned the 1000 character classic from his uncle and entered Doksan Public Elementary School in 1918 when he was 10 years old.
그 유닛하고 친한 친구의 황종진이라고 있는데 유닛하고 좀 한 살 밑이에요. 그런데 머리가 좋아. 그래서 이 한자를 외운다든가 일본말을 한다든가 이런 것을 유닛하고 좀 낫다 이게. 그러니까 유닛하고 어떻게든지 이기려고. 야, 빌어먹을 부분 나도 가서 일본말이나 배워야 되겠다.
Yun Bong-gil always had to finish what he started. But he failed to graduate from Doksan Elementary School. At the time, under the pretext of giving a modern education, Japan was carrying out a colonial education to eradicate the Korean spirit.
우리말을 쓰지 못하게 하고 일본말을 쓰게 했고요. 또 이제 우리의 역사 이런 것들을 굉장히 무시하고 나쁘게 보고 또 일본의 역사를 우월하게 이렇게 심어줬죠.
대놓고 그렇게 교육을 했었다는 거죠.
아, 그럼요.
Children could not speak Korean at school, and Japanese became the official language. The educational process of unifying Korean and Japan was painful. In the midst of these turbulent times, Emperor Gojong passed away in 1919. Yun Bong-gil was 11 years old. Emperor Gojong's death was sudden. Rumors spread that he had been poisoned, and people flooded out to the streets on the day of his funeral. The 200,000 people who came out that day waved the Korean flag in their hands. This was the March 1st movement. The movement spread like wildfire. The Japanese oppression had gone too far, and resistance was unstoppable. The tide of the independence movement reached Yun Bong-gil's hometown of Doksan. On April 3rd at Hanne-jang, the base of a trader group for hundreds of years, people gathered and participated in the independence movement. That day, seven people were arrested and a young man was killed. His name was In Han-soo.
여기서 그때 장문한 이한수 이분들이 그 한 수십 명 정도 하고 만세를 하시고 그리고 일본 헌병이 와서 예 찌르고 그게 대략 어디다 뭐 이런 게 있어요.
여기일 거야, 여기.
딱 여기야.
The young villagers carried his body and barged their way into the headquarters of the Japanese military police. Yun Bong-gil was at the site. What he saw that day was the rage of his people. The word independence was engraved in the heart and mind of an 11-year-old boy. Because of the independence movement, all schools were shut down. Yun Bong-gil's school, Doksong Elementary, was also closed, so instead he attended the village schoolhouse. 2 years later, orders were given to reopen all the schools and to shut down the village schoolhouses, but Yun Bong-gil did not return. Having learned at the village schoolhouse for the past 2 years, he went to Ochi Sosuk, a village school, and continued his studies there. Here he learned all the classics of Confucianism. Yun Bong-gil studied here from 1921 to 1928.
Okay. 성유로이가 경영하는 그 이제 오치소득.
그럼 여기가 이제 여기가 딱 그 턴가요?
아니요, 이 집이 요 집 이 집이 이렇게.
윤 봉길 was one of Song Ju-rok's favorite students. His nom de plume, Mae-hon, was given to him by his teacher. Song Ju-rok was a descendant of Song Sam-moon. Yun Bong-gil's scholastic performance was excellent, and at 16 he won first place at Ochi Sosuk's poetry competition. When he was 18, he published 3 poetry books. He was, in fact, quite a poet. Believing in foundation of life. Praying for a rich harvest this year. The hearts of farmers working hard grows larger. The spotted specks in the fields, our husbands plowing. The reddish rocks, our lamps at the sides of wives weaving. The arrow shadow in the goblet changes into a viper on a bow. And because of the wind in the folding screen, traces of ink are blown, becoming flies. Now I know that every grain comes from hard work. Lying down in a gazebo, I slowly fall asleep.
되게 진취적이셨던 것 같아서 그 끊임없이 책을 되게 좋아하셔가지고 그 당시 그 주막집에 있는 그 친구분은 이제 그 당시 나오는 뭐 개벽이라든지 이런 잡지를 구독하셨던 것 같아요. 그러면 그 잡지를 빨리 읽도록 해가지고 자기가 이제 빌려다 보시고 그걸 통해가지고 이제 균형을 잡으려고 한 거죠. 그러니까 그게 아셨던 것 같아요. 그 유학적인 걸로는 자기 어떤 인생관이라든가 이걸 갖다가 그 사람의 됨됨이를 만들어야 되고 그것 바탕 위에서 이 새로운 문물이라든지 새로운 시대에 쫓아가야지만 그 하나의 완성된 세계를 살 수 있다는 그런 확신이 있으셨던.
At this time, he begins to read 개벽, a magazine with progressive ideas, and began to think about independence. It was also at this time that he encountered this poem. Now someone else's land. Does spring come to a plundered field? The sun shines over me. Where the blue sky and the green fields meet, I follow the narrow path between the rice paddies and walk as if in a dream. Soaked in green smells, amidst green laughter and green sorrow, I walk all day limping. Perhaps I'm stuck with a spring spirit, but now, the field is plundered, and even spring may be taken away. Song Sam-moon, one of the 6 martyred ministers, and Min Yong-hwan, who committed suicide opposing the Ulsa Treaty. While studying at Ochi Sosuk, Yun Bong-gil learned about Song Sam-moon's integrity and the love of Min Yong-hwan had for his country. 19-year-old Yun Bong-gil began to be troubled. There is a place he went every time he was troubled. Sodaksa Temple. The reason why Yun Bong-gil came to this temple was because of Monk Manggong. Monk Manggong was a monk an independence fighter. He opposed the Buddhism policies of the Japanese General Government of Korea and asserted that the world must become one. Though Yun Bong-gil studied Confucianism, he was not close-minded. Here at the temple, he deeply engraved the spirit of Monk Mangong in his mind. He thought that reforming the nation's spirit would be the first step in regaining the country.
6.25 맨든 사람들이 전부 일본으로 보살사 가지고 가는 앞장을 섰다 이거예요. 6.25 한 사람들이 그래서 이게 안 되겠다. 6.25 정신을 바로잡아야 되겠다. 그런 뜻에서 홍성에 6.25 무식회라는 것을 만들었어요. 만주사 독립운동하던 사람들이 내려와 가지고서.
Although Confucianism had been the foundation of Joseon for 600 years, it was also the reason for the loss of the country. The leader of the Confucian group was Kim Bok-hwan, a guerrilla fighter. Their goal was to regain the country through the spirit of Confucianism.
거기에서 얻은 게 뭘 얻었느냐면 독립운동이 실질적으로 우리나라에서 어떻게 시작이 돼 있느냐 그것을 배웠고 상해의 임시정부가 어떠한 성격을 가졌고 그래가지고서 상해가는 이제 그 연습을 한 시민이.
Around this time, something happened that greatly shook Yun Bong-gil. There used to be a cemetery near the village school of Oje Sasol. The incident happened in 1926 when 17-year-old Yun Bong-gil was studying at the village school. A farmer in the village dug up all the headstones in the cemetery and came to Yun Bong-gil. He wanted to know which one was his father's. The farmer was illiterate and could not read. From that moment on, Yun Bong-gil knew what he had to do.
그렇죠. 예, 예. 그 사건, 예, 그 사건이 생겨서 이제 그걸 보고 야 이게 문맹 퇴치를 안 하면은 우리나라가 도저히 잘 살 방법이 없다.
With his fellow classmates, he opened a night school at his house and began to teach people. This was the beginning of Yun Bong-gil's rural enlightenment movement.
윤희사 할아버지는 두더지처럼 그저 해가 뜨기 전부터 일어나서 밭일을 그런 거예요. 그래야 가난을 몰아낼 수가 있으니까. 그게 윤희사는 그 정신이 그 바뀌어졌어. 어떻게 바뀌어졌느냐. 우리가 먹고 살고 먹고 되면은 나라 차지해야 된다. 이게. 나라 차지면은 가난도 역시 그저 극복할 수가 있다.
Here he taught Korean history, mathematics, science, and farming techniques. Although he had studied Confucianism, he was not authoritative or close-minded. Rather, he was a new generation man with new ideas.
농촌 개몽 운동하시면서 야학을 하실 때도 집 나 우선 여자부터 가르쳤대요. 근데 이제 그 중에 저희 할머니도 이제 학생이었던 거죠. 그래서 할머니도 할아버지를 통해서 한글을 배우셨고 여동생들도 그 야학을 통해서 이제 한글을 배우셨는데 똑같이 못해도 저희 할머니는 한 번도 야단 안 치고 이제 다른 분들만 그러니까 성격은 급하셔가지고 왜 이거를 못 알아 듣느냐 하지만 저희 할머니는 항상 특별 대우셨다 그러면서 그런 얘기들을 하시고
He believed that without knowledge, nothing could be done. Education was the utmost priority in regaining the country. Based on his experiences and knowledge, he began to write a three-part book. It was called Nongmin Tokbon, or An Agrarian Reader. Part one of the book has been lost, but part two, Enlightenment, writes about what individuals should know, such as etiquette, and talks about national awareness and national spirit. Part three, The Future of Farmers, speaks of building an ideal state centered on farmers and laborers, and presents the way forward for farmers.
일제가 그 한국을 보호구로 만든다고 하는 저 그런 조약을 체결한 후에 저 한국의 한국인들은 그 일제에 대해서 항거를 하죠. 항거하는 방법이 크게 두 가지인데 하나는 무기를 들고 일제하고 항전하는 것이고 그게 이제 의병들이고 그다음에 또 하나는 우리가 왜 일본한테 이렇게 저 나라를 그 뺏기게 됐냐 그것은 국가가 힘이 없어서 그러니까 그 국가의 힘을 길러야 된다. 국가의 힘을 길르려면 국민을 똑똑하게 그 계몽시켜야 된다. 그래서 이제 국민을 계몽시키는 운동이죠.
The year he graduated from Ochi Sosok, Yun Bong-gil forms a new organization for the Rural Enlightenment Movement. It was called Buhongwon of the Mokge Agrarian Committee. Yun Bong-gil and the Mokge Agrarian Committee held a ceremony for Buhongwon in March 1929, and on April 23, 1929, it was formally founded. The Buhongwon wanted to revive villages through production increase campaigns, organization of consumer purchase co-ops, use of domestic goods, promotion of side jobs, and improvement in daily life. Buhongwon also formed a book club and held enlightenment lectures and discussion groups. The Woljinho was formed to put the organization's objectives into action. The purpose of its establishment was to build one's own future through self-sufficiency. Their goal was achieving Korea's independence by cultivating skills and reviving the economy.
다시 말하면 월진회한테 그 오다를 주는 기관이 그 이제 부흥원이에요. 다시 말하면 부흥원 철학을 연구하는 데고 그 철학을 실천하는 데가 월진회다 이거죠.
The Woljinhae was run by the fees paid by its members. 37 people, including Hwang Jong-jin, Yun Bong-gil's sworn brother, were the founding members, and Yun Bong-gil was their leader. Continuing the spirit of Yun Bong-gil, the Woljinhae still exists today. The name Woljinhae reflects the desperate times when it was first founded. It means the sun has lost its light. We must go to the moon to light up our land.
그래야지 사실 윤봉에서
우리나라에서 다른 데서는 전혀 찾아볼 수 없었던 방법들인 거죠.
그렇죠. 처음으로 도입을 한 그런 운동이 시작이 된 거죠. 기술 농사 기술 같은 것도.
The Buhongwon had four objectives: to carry out production increase campaigns and domestic goods campaigns, organize consumers, purchase co-ops, and promote side jobs. In order to achieve these goals, the Woljinhae planned to revive the rural economy in an entirely new way. They traded directly with factories to supply daily necessities and jointly sold agricultural goods that were harvested. It was a type of co-op. They also looked for ways to increase the profits of farms and made it into a reality.
그때만 하더라도 고구마가 들어왔을 때요. 근데 고구마 싹 내는 것이 장차 어려워. 그래서 고구마 싹을 어떻게 못 내느냐. 윤희사가 이제 생각해서 만들어낸 거예요. 땅을 깊이 파자. 이거만한 땅을 깊이 파면 지열이 나. 거기다가 고구마를 이렇게 재해 놓고서 그거 이제 보온을 하면 거기서 싹이 나오면 그런 것 갖다 심는다. 또 닭도 치는 것도 저걸 했고 오리 치는 것도 저거 나무 심는 것도 하여튼 돈이 될 수 있고 증산이 될 수 있는 것은 뭐든지 해. 그때 이제 시작을 한 거예요.
They also implemented a parcel out system for farmers who did not have the money to buy pigs. They would buy the pigs for farmers who couldn't buy them. And once the pigs gave birth, the farmers were allowed to keep half the litter, while the other half were parceled out one by one to other farmers.
아이 그때 그 가사에 도움이 되죠. 돼지 한두 마리 길러 옛날에 한두 마리 길렀거든. 그게 돈이 어디서 나와요? 그런 거 팔아서 돈 나오는 거지. 그리고 옛날에는 명절 때야 돼지 고기 한 점씩 먹거든. 그게 다 돈이거든.
Yun Bong-gil also developed new groups to get the young men of the village together. One was the Suam Sports Association. In order to provide a place for them to exercise, he set fire to the Munjungsan Mountain.
이 버섯 농장 이 일대가 전부 백사장이에요. 그 모래 백사장. 이게 작은데 산이에요. 이 골프장이 있는 데서부터 이 산 전체가 그 윤의산의 산이었다.
In an area of 10,000 square meters, people kicked balls and exercised to develop their physical strength. He believed healthy bodies led to healthy minds. Yun Bong-gil also began village improvement projects with the young men.
그래서 마을 청년들 올 적에는 괜히 삽 이런 걸 가지고 오라고 해가지고 지금은 우리가 평캐 차 타고 여기 건너왔지만 그 당시 이 내가 다 증검다리거든요. 다리 같은 거 다 수선하고 이런 일을 그 청년들한테 시켜가지고.
The rural enlightenment movement was also a way to build Yun Bong-gil's own utopia. Yun Bong-gil encouraged people through many lectures. He believed the nation could only be revived by waking up each and every person. February 29, 1929 was a day of celebrations commemorating the founding of the Bunghungwon. Yun Bong-gil put on a talent show, one of which was a play. It was called The Hare and the Fox, an adaptation of one of Aesop's fables. As a hare and a tortoise contemplated over how to split a piece of bread, a fox appears in front of them. The fox boasts that he can divide the bread equally and tricks the hare and the tortoise. He splits the bread in half and, saying that one looks bigger than the other, he takes a bite out of the bigger half. Now the other half is bigger. So the fox takes a bite out of that one. The other half is bigger again. The fox goes back and forth eating both halves of the bread and eventually eats all of it. He is not sorry at all. It was his plan all along. Saying that he'll divide their bread in half next time, the fox goes on his way. The fox represented Japan, while the hare and the tortoise represented the Korean people. He opened the eyes of the people to Japan, who exploited them in the name of modernization. The following day, Yun Bong-gil is arrested by Japanese policemen and tortured. He became a watched man by the Japanese from then on and could no longer be active.
일제가 한국을 식민지 지배할 때는 그 각 지역에 그 경찰들을 파견해서 경찰 주재소가 있잖아요. 그 주재소의 임무라고 하는 것이 그 지역에서 소위 일제에 대해서 저항하는 운동 이런 운동들을 철저하게 탄압하는 것이죠. 이제 윤봉길 이사가 고향에서 그런 그 농촌 계몽 운동 무슨 뭐 그 월진의 부흥원 이런 걸 조직해서 농촌 계몽 운동을 하잖아요. 그것도 그 당시 그 관할 주재소에서 그런 활동을 못하게 탄압을 하고 그러죠.
When Japan began their colonial rule, they needed a system to colonize the country. The first thing they did was carry out a land survey project. This was to collect land taxes. They also established the Dongyan Colonization Company. The company was used to own land in granary regions and transport the rice back to Japan by train. They were recklessly exploiting the people in the name of modernization. The Korean peninsula became more and more impoverished. Those who rebelled were threatened by swords and guns. The area that was most damaged was Jeollado province because it had many plains. Around that time, a crucial incident took place. It was the November 3rd Students' Independent Movement, one of the three major independence movements. More commonly known as the Gwangju Students' Independence Movement, it began at Naju Station. This is where the Naju Station ribbon incident happened. The year was 1929. At the time, Japan had been strategically plundering the grains from Naju Plains. For this purpose, there was even a street called Ginza, where the Japanese resided. Japanese and Korean students living in Naju were going to school in Gwangju by train. The Japanese and Korean students had nothing but bad feelings for each other. When a Japanese student pulled the hair ribbon of a Korean female student, insulting her, there was a clash between the Japanese and Korean students who saw this, but only the Korean students were battered by the police.
조선인 주제에 왜 되드냐 이겁니다. 이 조선인이라는 것은 조선인 자체를 의미한 게 아니고 1등 국민인 우리 일본인한테 왜 2등 국민인 너희들이 되드냐 이런 의미였습니다.
Two days later, using the ribbon incident as an excuse, there was another clash between the students on the train. But the train master only berated the Korean students. The Korean students in the Gwangju area had gone on strike to participate in the independence movement before, and they did not let this incident go. On November 3rd, one of Japan's four major holidays, they refused to pay respects to the Shinto shrine and went out to the streets. According to the lunar calendar, this was also October 3rd, National Foundation Day of Korea. Over 300 students shouted for independence on the streets. It was the largest demonstration after the March 1st movement. The Gwangju students' independence movement became the crucial trigger for Yun Bong-gil, who had been looking for a new way after his hands had been tied by the hare and tortoise play. After much contemplation, he chooses to go down an entirely different path.
이제 윤봉길 이사가 시골에 있지만 그런 소식들을 아주 많이 들었어요. 이제 그걸 보면서 이게 이제 자기가 그런 원수를 갚아야 되겠다. 또 어떤 그런 우리 저 민족의 독립운동을 해야 되겠다. 그러기 위해서는 지금 이 일제가 탄압, 그런 경찰이나 이런 탄압이 지속되는 여기서는 그걸 할 수 없겠다. 윤봉길 이사가 중국으로 망명하는 직접적인 계기는 물론 자기가 농촌 계몽운동하다가 벽에 부딪히는 것도 있지만 결정적인 계기는 광주 학생운동이었습니다.
In the spring of the following year, he decides to put his decision into action. 장불출가 생불환. It means, once a man leaves the house, he will not return alive until he fulfills his objective. He put this memo on a bookshelf and left home. At the time, he had a wife of 4 years and a baby boy.
그달따라 좀 특별하게 저희 할머니한테 이제 물 한 잔을 달래서 이제 물 한 그릇을 드리니까 마시지 않고 이제 이렇게 놓으시고는 저희 아버지를 안고는 내가 밖에 나가서 정말 돈을 많이 벌어서 너를 공부를 충분히 시켜주겠다 이러고는 이제 놓고 나가셨다 그러거든요. 그러니까 저희 할머니 생각엔 참 평소에 안 하던 말을 하니까 참 그 표현으로는 변덕스럽다. 왜 저런 말을 할까?
That was the last time he saw his family. As he boarded the train to seek asylum, he wrote a letter to his mother. 그런데 이 편지는 잘못된 사람에게 갔습니다. 일본군의 군인들에게 갔습니다. 그래서 그의 결심을 나라를 위해 싸우기 위해 Yun Bong-gil 갇혀있는 평양도 지방에서 5개월 갇혀있습니다. 그의 해방을 위해 신휘주 그리고 만추리아 그리고 마지막으로 칭다오에 During the day, he worked at a launderer, and at night, he gave lectures on labor, preparing to go to Shanghai. His ultimate goal was to go to the provisional government. In the letters he wrote, we can see his unwavering determination despite the hardships of his life of exile. Why do people live? They live to achieve their ideals. What are ideals? It is to succeed in their purpose. See how the flowers bloom and the trees bear fruit. He also wrote to his wife and son, who would be mourning the loss of a husband and father. You will always have a father. This was also a promise he made to himself. In August 1931, Yun Bong-gil finally arrived in Shanghai a year and a half after he left home. At the time, Shanghai was an international city where all Western powers and consulates were gathered. Korea's provisional government was also located inside France's extraterritorial jurisdiction. Yun Bong-gil worked at a hat factory and led labor campaigns. He also met An Jung-gung's brother, An Gong-gung. Shanghai was in troubled times because of the Manbosan incident, a clash between Korean and Chinese farmers.
Manbosan이라고 하는 데는 지금 중국의 그 장춘하고 그 길림 그 사이에 있는 시골 마을입니다. 거기 이제 한국인들이 가서 농사를 짓는데 그 농사 짓려면 그 물 되는 거 있잖아요. 그 수로를 만들다가 이제 그런 충돌이 있었던 것이죠.
Chinese farmers destroyed dikes, and conflicts arose where Chinese and Japanese armed police were mobilized. Japan exaggerated the reports dividing the Korean and Chinese people. Because of reports that the Chinese were harassing Korean farmers, attacks on Chinese occurred across Korea. The incident only comes to a close after the Donga Ilbo reported that it was a scheme by Japan.
한국 사람들이 중국 만주 지역이나 중국 대륙에 가서 저 많이 망명을 해서 그쪽 가서 활동을 하잖아요. 거기서 활동하려고 하면 중국 사람들하고 협력하고 중국 사람들이 도움이 없이는 안 되죠. 그러니까 바로 일제가 그 만보산에서 일어난 그런 일을 가지고 한국 중국을 이간질시킨 것이죠.
Japan's plot was for nothing. Chiang Kai-shek of the Kuomintang government delivered a plaque of appreciation to the Donga Ilbo, promising friendly ties, and the incident came to an end. It seems as if peace was restored in Shanghai. However, the provisional government in Shanghai had new problems. It was 13 years since it was formed, but the independence movement was at a standstill. The provisional government was divided from within, and there seemed to be no way out. The independence of Korea seemed to be more difficult than ever. It was at this time the Shanghai incident happened. As a way to suppress the independence movement and to turn the West's attention away from the Manchurian independence movement, Japan bribed some Chinese to beat up Japanese monks. As a result, a battle ensued between Japan's Navy land forces and China's 19th Route Army. This incident revealed Japan's ambition to invade mainland China.
일본이 만주를 뺏었다 이거. 뺏어 가지고서 만주 제국을 만드는 거예요. 그래 가지고서 중국의 그 박이라는 청나라의 왕자를 데려다가 만주의 황제로 만들었다 이거. 그러니까 전 세상이 전 세계에 있는 나라가 안 된다. 그 만주국을 해체해라. 그래서 중국으로 돌려보내라. 그래가지고 여론이 나빠졌어. 여론이 나빠지니까 일본이 이 여론 나빠진 여론을 어떻게 해야 사그러뜨릴 수가 있느냐.
Shanghai was facing troubled times. Yun Bong-gil was working as a greengrocer, keeping an eye on Japan's movements. He was looking for an opportunity to revive the spark of the independence movement. Having won the battle, the Japanese military were still posted in Shanghai. Having declared an armistice agreement, Japan announced Victory Day celebrations on the day of their emperor's birthday before they withdrew their military. The only items allowed inside were the Japanese flag, a water canteen, and a lunchbox. This was his chance. Yun Bong-gil went to see Kim Gu, the leader of the provisional government. They planned a revolt on the day of the celebrations. preparations were carried out in secret. A Chinese man, Zhang Siju, made the bomb shaped like a lunchbox and water canteen. General Kim Hong-il, a logistics officer for the Chinese army, was also there. After two tests, the bomb was completed. This is Hong Kong Park, now Lu Xun Park. Before the big day, Yun Bong-gil surveyed the area and made his plans. The place where the event was held is now a pond, and there is a monument where Yun Bong-gil threw the bomb. After Yun Bong-gil planned his revolt and 4 days before the D-Day, he officially joined the Korea Patriotic Corps formed by Kim Gu. The Korean Patriotic Corps was an independent movement organization established in 1931. It was a secret society formed for the purpose of assassinating Japanese leaders. Kim Gu headed the group, while An Gong-gun, Kim Sok, and Lee Soo-bong ran the organization. Lee Bong-chan, Yun Bong-gil, Yu Sang-gun, and Lee Duk-ju also fought with their lives. At the time, Yun Bong-gil's second son was born, a son he would never see. 2 days before D-Day, he writes his will at the request of Kim Gu. As long as there are blood and bones in your body, you must become brave fighters for Chosun. Hold the Taeguk flag up high and come to my empty grave to pour me a glass of liquor. Young lads, whose blood boils, do you know why the Japanese are crawling all over our lands and mountains? Young bloods, do you not know why they have come and are not leaving? Young lads, be ready. Wear your uniforms, draw your swords, and raise your guns. It is time to march as the bugles blow. This is how Kim Gu remembers the morning of that day. Early in the morning, I went to Kim Hae-san's house with Yun and had breakfast with him for the last time. Looking at Yun's face, he looked calm, as if he was merely a farmer eating his breakfast. There were two bombs. One was shaped as a lunchbox to commit suicide later. The one shaped as a water canteen was to be detonated over the platform. The success or failure of this deed was now in the hands of Yun Bong-gil. Before leaving, Yun Bong-gil gives his new watch to Kim Gu. And Kim Gu gives his old watch to Yun Bong-gil. Kim Gu's watch became Yun Bong-gil's keepsake, while Kim Gu kept the watch until the day he died. The ceremony finally began. Speaking Japanese fluently, Yun Bong-gil passed through security and took his place near the platform. The ceremony began at 9 and ended at 11. After the first part was over, the diplomats and guests returned home, and only the Japanese remained. 20 minutes later, the Shanghai Victory Day ceremony prepared by Japanese residents began. On the platform was Yoshinori Shirakawa, general of the expeditionary forces in Shanghai, and 7 other important figures. This was the moment. From 5 meters away, Yun Bong-gil succeeded in throwing the water canteen bomb. He was arrested on sight. This incident was splashed all over the headlines around the world. Up until now, Western states had been lenient towards Japan's rule, but they were now paying attention to Japan's atrocities. Due to the bombing, the 9th Division commander, Ueda Kenkichi, lost his right leg, while the 3rd Fleet commander was blinded in his right eye. Japan's minister to China also lost a leg. The consul general to China was also injured. Yoshinori Shirakawa, general of the expeditionary forces in Shanghai, died.
테러하고 의열투쟁은 완전히 다릅니다. 의열투쟁은 그 대상이 분명합니다. 하지만 테러는 대상이 누군지도 모르게 불특정하죠. 윤봉길이자도 마찬가지입니다. 자기가 선언서에서 적의 장교를 도륙하기로 맹세하나이다. 그 윤봉길사의 목표는 적의 장교를 죽이는 것이죠. 그러니까 그 단상으로만 던집니다. 그 앞에는 엄청나게 많은 일반 학생들이 있는데 글로 폭탄을 던진 많은 사람들을 죽일 텐데 그렇죠. 그다음에 두 번째 차이점은 의열투쟁은 자기가 행위를 하고 나서 자신의 행위를 떳떳하게 밝힙니다. 근데 테러는 그 행위를 하고 나서 그 떳떳하게 밝히지 않고 그걸 숨기죠.
Yoshinori Shirakawa was Japan's most decorated general, favored by the emperor. After the bombing, the emperor sent doctors to care for Yoshinori Shirakawa, who had to undergo 12 surgeries. But he eventually died a month later.
The 윤봉길 의거가 우리 독립운동사에 차지하는 것이 그 안중근 의사가 이등방문을 처단하잖아요. 그 다음에 이봉창 의사가 일본 천황을 처단하려고 폭탄을 던지고, 그 다음에 윤봉길 의사가 홍구공원에서 의거를 하고, 이것은 이제 우리 독립운동사의 3대 쾌거다.
Yun Bong-gil was tried at military court. Trying a civilian at military court was unprecedented. He gave his statements on his actions.
윤봉길 의사는 바로 일본으로 압송하지 않고 그 일본이 상해에 있는 일본 총영사관 그 지하실에 감금을 하고 있었습니다. 이제 그 이유는 그 총영사관에 감금을 하고 있으면 그 백범 김구가 그 윤봉길을 구출하러 올 거다.
Japan singled out Kim-gu as the mastermind of the plot. Reports were controlled to minimize the effect of the incident. Kim-gu himself declared in the papers that he was behind the bombing. He became a wanted man, and a reward of nearly $20 million was placed on him. Yun Bong-gil remained dignified throughout the trial, and the judge rendered a death sentence. Asking if he had any last words, Yun Bong-gil replied, "I was prepared for the worst and have nothing to say." However, autumn passed and the death sentence was not executed. Yun Bong-gil was handed over to the military police and tortured. Japan was trying to use him to lure out Kim-gu. Eventually in December, Yun Bong-gil was transferred to the 9th Division prison in Kanazawa. At 7:15 a.m. December 19, 1932, the day after he was transferred, as if trying to exact revenge for the 9th Division commander Ueda's severed leg, he was executed by a firing squad at a valley in Kanazawa. He was only 25.
사실 상해 임정이 거의 유명무실화 됐었어요. 그런데 윤봉길 의사를 만나가지고 그 거사에서 선곡을 하는 바람에 임시정부도 세상에 알려졌고 특히 중국이 7억 인구가 모드는 것을 한국 청년이 했다 해서 장개석 정부가 그때부터 임정을 인정을 하고 전적으로 지원을 했죠.
그 당시에 국제 열강이라고 하는 나라들도 미국이나 뭐 영국이나 뭐 프랑스나 다 자기들도 식민 통치를 하는 상황이었기 때문에 일본에 대해서 그렇게 이제 뭐 적대시한다라든가 침략자로 응징을 해야 된다라든가 그런 그 뭐 예외적인 판단은 없었죠. 그런 상황이었기 때문에 이런 그 윤봉길 의거로 인해서 일본의 침략상이 전 세계에 폭로되게 된 것이죠.
After liberation, Kim-gu began efforts to find Yun Bong-gil's remains. A small hidden place in Kanazawa, where people rarely go.
이 33년 동안에 여기 가는 일본 사람들 여기 오랑캐들이 바로 바로 비리를 당했고 그래서 그 여기 자리가 바로 소관로입니다. 쓰레기통으로 가져와가지고.
Kim Gu frequented Yun Bong-gil's home until the day he died. Yun Bong-gil's remains were found 3 kilometers south from the execution ground. A young man who fought for his country's independence with all his heart, Yun Bong-gil. He was a hero who revived the spark of the independence movement.